Umar, baby, you got some explaining to do about this one. Skipping all introduction, let's get into this thing, because last time I was talking about Mr. Johnson, I was a little bit on the sauce. We'll be sober for this one, because I'm really curious to hear what he's got to say about, well, he won't talk about this.
And if you're thinking about writing somebody in prison, this is the website, it's writeaprisoner.com.
Umar, I thought you said that that we are generalizing them, picking Pookies and Ray Rays. What happened, baby?
And then they'll have like a little bio. I'm weak because this man said dreads and I have all my teeth. I mean, that's a good quality.
I got all my teeth. Oh, my God. And I'm just going to start off right here now. If you are not a woman that does any of this stupidity, please don't get mad because I'm not talking about you. Don't be part of the hive mind and getting all upset because I'm saying what the deplorables are doing. You don't need common sense to realize that dating a prisoner is a bad idea with all the men out there. Unless you into that bad boy thing.
Before you write anybody, look at what they're in prison for so you can go to your state.
I'm glad you at least said that. Look at what they in for. Did they kill someone? Did they rob someone? Do they have warrants?
States, offender search. And then you can't even see violations they had while in prison because you want to make sure that you're not dealing with the crazy person. So you also want.
Says the person who's talking to a prisoner, and you're saying, I don't want to deal with a crazy person. To me, it takes a crazy person to go look up men in prison. That just means that you're so low in the totem pole of attraction to any man that you have to pick the one person that's part of a chain gang.
I want to do even more research. This is a Facebook group, Write a Prisoner Exposed.
And I just want to throw it out there. Look at all the... They are putting way more effort into finding a man in prison to see what he got arrested for than actual relationships on the other side. Let that make sense.
So people who wrote them, they'll give reviews if they had a bad experience.
I think the bars behind him says it's a bad experience. I'm not saying that men can't be better or people that go to prison can't be better, but... You jump to a prisoner? Like, you can't make this up. You literally cannot make this up.
Obviously, I would not recommend writing an inmate. But if you do, be careful because this thing is crimes online that you won't see. So you want to do all your research. And I mean, obviously, you don't want to write anybody who is in there for kid stuff. And if you do, like.
Praise be. That's the line.
I always knew where the line was drawn. And you just stepped over it, buddy boy.
Okay.
You're sick, so. But yeah, just be careful, because don't be a dumb bitch like me. And got motherfuckers still calling your phone. If this video ever blows up, like, I'm pretty sure I'm going to get a lot of phone calls.
Yeah. Don't be a dumb bitch like her. Find a man that's not a thug on the inside or the outside. You know the guys that have great jobs and have education and all their teeth, you should probably go after them. Dumbass. Okay. All right, me and my incarcerated fiance. Oh, dear God. All right, let's do this. All right, me and my incarcerated fiance trying for a baby through the... Did he put his semen in the mail? Oh, dear God. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Oh, God, no! Oh, this can't be happening.
Okay, so that's him. Oh, I can see why you like him. Umar, what happened? I thought this wasn't a thing. I thought this wasn't a thing, Umar. What happened? Oh, my God. Yo, like, Go ahead. I love to hear you blame black men. I'm talking about the other black men you wanted to be clear about. Tell me how you going to fix this problem.
This is the shit I'm talking about, and it ain't even her. It's the people in the comments.
Agree with that. I agree on that.
I saw a comment in there talking about this is my sign. No, it's not. Stop having babies out of your selfish wants.
And here's the other thing I want to throw in there. The booty warrior has got a wife. That tells you everything. This dude, great men in prison. He offered his service, and if they said no, they would grape him. And I'm sure she saw a video of him. He's out of prison finally. And guess what? He married. He be married. They would prefer a man that raped other men in prison than you. Black girl magic.
Why would you knowingly traumatize a child by having a child with a man that's actively incarcerated? Y'all really don't be caring about these kids. Y'all selfish as fuck.
Nope, they don't. I mean, I'm sorry it took you. You just figured it out now. For about 50 years, they haven't cared about their kids. You know, that thing that Umar Johnson doesn't want to talk about. You've been breeding with these same type of dudes. And there's black guys, and then there's Pookies and Ray Rays. You can tell by the way they talk, the way they carry themselves, and the fact that their education is no higher than the fifth grade. Possibly. Oh, my God. This is so embarrassing. Like, if I was a woman right now, I'd be freaking embarrassed. Straight up. I would be so freaking embarrassed. like, I know y'all are mad about this. You have to be mad. Like, seriously. How do you even... Okay. All right.
Should you take friends to be a lawful wedding husband?
Oh, hell no. This dude's in a stereotypical prison cell like he's Zorro. Breaking out of Mexico. He's got the cartoon set. This is as bad. Listen to me. This is as bad as trying to marry yourself and say that, well, I chose to be. No, nobody wanted you. But this is different. Y'all talk about how y'all don't want no thugs. You want this, that, and the third. You want the bad boys.
This motherfucker's the best out. By the virtue of authority vested in me as Deputy Commissioner of Civil Marriages, I now pronounce you married. Congratulations. Talking about murder.
She can't even kiss him. That goes against protocol. Oh my God. Y'all stupid.
Hopefully. They're not talking about pedophiles. They're not talking about those type of men.
And you look at the comments. Look at the comments. Oh my God, they're so wonderful. I'm glad she found her man. This shows you how low they have sunken. That they skipped all those men, made excuses why it is to go out with the bad boy. Jeez, I'm glad that the pedophile thing is where you draw the line.
That they're talking about are usually drug dealers.
Oh, and I know. Oh, drug dealers. Oh, the people who put poison in the streets and get kids addicted to it and the kids getting shot. Oh, I'm glad that that's okay for you.
Know that it's bad, illegal. They should do the right thing. Yes.
You mean not sell drugs at all? The fact that we're even having this conversation, oh dear God.
But the thing that attracts these women to these men so much.
Say it.
Is that they have a provider mentality. Oh. They have a protect and provide.
They do. And hopefully they will do that when their rival gang member sees them and starts popping shots at you. I'm hoping that they'll protect you from the barrage of gunfire that the guy who's a scholar or the guy who basically has gotten with honors as a lawyer would never have to worry about unless it's someone he's defending. God, the cute ones are the dumbest people on the planet.
Mentality. And a lot of those men take care of their woman, take care of their mother, take care of the women in their lives, and so they do that at any cost. And a lot of those men don't have access. They may be of a very low class where they don't have the network, they don't have the know-how, they don't have the education.
All right, I'm gonna hold off on this one. I'm gonna tell you something right now. Gentlemen, I swear I will pimp slap you myself. If you come across any woman that has had kids from some dude like this, and she's like, oh, I'm settling. If you accept that, you're an idiot. She basically is talking about the same type of guys that they claim that passport bros are, the ones that are undesirables. Oh, they're not this, and they don't have a lot of money. They will choose the dude that doesn't have any money, that's a bad boy, that's tatted up, that's got the pretty boy look. That's what they're going for. And this sucks because there's a ton of women that would never do this. They're the smart ones that found the right one. These idiots are so used to toxic nature that they will continue to go towards it. Personally, I say, do you, boo, because that gives me more content to talk about.
To do that. And of course, some people say, well, there's no excuse for that.
All right, guys, so let's just pause right here, okay? Because she's basically saying, if you're not a drug dealer, or some sort of, you know, criminal, then you're not a provider, okay?
Those men usually do, but the problem is it's illegal. And so they go to prison, and then the women are like, oh, you know, the good men are in prison. Like, all these guys who are just, and you know, I can already hear you guys like, oh, so I'm just nothing because I'm just out here doing the right thing. Like, no, that's not what it is. It's just that. It's just that. Guys who tend to just be average are just, I'm sorry, but I'm not sorry. It's boring.
Boom! Thank you. I'm glad she said that. The men that do the right thing are boring. The guys who are the douchebags, oh, they get their never regions wet. There you go. I'm glad you said that. You put common sense behind you. You put your safety behind you. But they turn you on. They love that. Oh, you got them shackles. Oh, you could probably do that on me. I wonder what he did. Did you beat somebody up? I mean, I'll let it go if it was another woman. But, I'll let it go because maybe I want you to do that on me. I want you to understand something. This is why a lot of these type of women are stupid. They get what they deserve. You're an idiot. I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, they don't have fathers. No, you're dumb. You are mentally challenged, and not mentally challenged like the people who have no choice. You chose to be mentally challenged. I don't want to say the real word that I want to say because I know TikTok feels a certain way about how I speak. They're boring. Men, remember this. When you see some chick like this, walk away. Or if you're at that point, use them and then dump them.
Like, average is mundane. And it's not like, I don't mean average like, oh, you are an employee. Because any employee, that's not always average. But if you're willing to just be a cashier and then try to move your way up.
And I want you to remember this. She's downplaying you, but she's giving the dude with no education, maybe has all his teeth, and has got several priors as priority. Just remember that. Don't listen to a woman say, well, I wanted to live my best life and all this, have fun, and I'm ready to settle down. I swear to God, men, this is why I built this channel. Man the F up. Women will never respect you if you go out with the bottom of the barrel women like this. They're not settling for you. You are settling for them because you don't know your worth. Women like this, as cute as she is, she's cute, but she's a moron. She's an airhead. Do not fall for the looks. Be aware of them so that you know how to move.
And then you're also like, but girl, you got to work too, and we're going 50-50, and I need this, and I have all these demands, like, versus a guy who's like, I got you, I'm going to take care of you, I'm going to get your nails done, I'm going to get your hair done, I want to do this, I want to do that for you.
Come on. See, they want a daddy figure. That's exactly what it is. I'm going to use that line. They want a daddy figure. You want somebody that'll do all the bills for you, not ask you for a damn thing, but you want to talk about how you got all this money, but it's pointless because you won't spend the money on the man, but you still want the man to make more than you do. But then you'll go either, these type of women are the extreme. They either go extremely high, I'm a boss babe, I make six figures, I need some man to make way more than that. Or they go bottom of the barrel for the excitement, the dum-dums, the guys with the ankle bracelets who can't go on a date with you past 6 p.m. because, you know, parole officer, things like that. This is what modern women are left with. This is it. This is what they are left. This is what they are. Accept it and move on.
Actually, I'm about to go get it right now. Here, how much money do you need? Bam, bam, bam. I got you, girl. You this. Like, that's so attractive.
Fairy tale, Disney crap. Okay? I guess if you're a 9-to-5 guy with a decent job, a 401k, and you pay your taxes on time, apparently that's boring, right? She needs to be with a guy where he's a criminal. Okay? The fact that she could be hit with a stray bullet at any given time, apparently that's attractive.
Ain't that some shit? Damn, I hope TikTok doesn't hit me with that one. I'm going to edit this later. They want that type of guy. Men, y'all need to start learning how to move. Learn these type of women. Listen to how they speak. Everything they say will tell you what type of woman you're trying to get involved with. This is not cool. They're fun to have, to play with, all that good stuff. But for the most part, if you're looking for a real woman, you don't want none of that. Trust me. It's sad. It's pathetic. But I'm like, you know what? Fine with me. I found my queen. Now it's time for you to find yours. Hopefully she's not in the pen.